Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at how to control your Mac using only your keyboard. So if you prefer using your keyboard as much as possible and your mouse as little as possible, well, there's a lot you can do with your Mac if you know the proper key combinations. So the first thing you want to do is go to System Preferences, and under System Preferences go to Keyboard. And then make sure that you have this checked, using all your F keys as standard function keys. If you don't have it checked, that means that they'll be used as things like playing on iTunes, volume controls, brightness controls, things like that. And you have to press the FN key to do the opposite. But to make things simpler here, we want to have that checked, so pressing F1 means pressing F1, not lowering the brightness. Now once we have that, we go over to Keyboard Shortcuts. And here there's a bunch of different categories, but we're going to look today in the Keyboard and Text Input category. And you can see there's lots of cool things here. These are all the defaults. Yours may be different if you change them, so it's important to check what yours is so you can see before you try some of these out. So for instance, one of the ones here is to move focus to the menu bar. And you can see that's set to Control F2. So not Command key, not the key with the Apple on it, but Control. So you want to go and hit Control and F2, and you can see now that the Apple menu got highlighted at the top left hand corner. And I can use my arrow keys now to move through the menus, and if I want the down arrow to move down in there, and then I can use space or return to actually activate something. So for instance, we could go under About System Preferences, go down here, I'll hit Return, and I get the About System Preferences box. So that's how you navigate to the menu bar with just the keyboard and activate a menu there. You can do the same thing with the dock. You can see here we've got Move Focus to the Dock with Control and F3. And it brings up the dock, and I can use the arrows to move left to right, and even the up arrow to move up and see what's available there. In this case, recent documents, all sorts of things. And I can navigate using the arrow keys and actually select something. So if I wanted to open up a document, I could. So you can see here that we've got some other ones. We've got Control F4 to move to the next window. So you can move through all the different windows through all the apps using Control F4. And then if you want to go and use something in the toolbar of a window, you can use Control F5. So for instance, let's do Control F4 and we'll move to the next window, which is a Finder window here. We'll do Control F5, and we can see that now the back button at the top there has a highlight, and I can actually activate it by hitting the space bar, or I can do down arrow to actually activate what's on that menu. Now this is less than perfect because if I go to the right, I can't. Because the next item there, the forward button, is inactive and for some reason doesn't let you go forward anymore. If I go back there, now I have both forward and back buttons, so I can do Control F5 and I can move between those back and forth. So it's just going to allow me to do those, and it won't allow me to do the other items here at the top of the screen, unfortunately. Now you have tons of other keyboard shortcuts that are included in here, and the keyboard shortcuts in menus, so it's important to know those if you're going to control everything. For instance, if you go to the Finder here, you can use the Go menu. You can see there's tons of keyboard shortcuts here for going quickly to different folders, like for instance the download folder, the desktop folder. So if you learn all of those, it's much easier to get around with than just actually always going to the menu or the dock. So one of the things that a lot of people find surprising, if we just do Control F4 till we get all the way to the Safari window here. And in Safari, there's of course a lot of keyboard shortcuts here at the top that you can get to know, but a lot of people don't realize some very simple things. Like for instance, right here without any modification, I can choose the up and down arrow keys to actually scroll through this page. It's very easy to scroll through a web page, sometimes easier than using the mouse, especially since the scroll bar isn't always there. It's only there when you're actually actively scrolling, so sometimes it's hard to grab onto. Now one final setting to look at is the setting down here where you can change how keyboard access works, either to only go to text boxes and lists only, or to all controls. And you can see Control F7 will actually let you change that. It's the first item up here. So for instance, let's go to the Finder here, and in the Finder I will use Control F5 and I will go back and forth, you can see, between selecting something in the Finder here, and Control F5 will then go up to the search bar. If I go and do Control F7 to change how that works, I now find that Control F5 goes between the toolbar at the top and the items there in the window. Now the last part's a little tricky. You'll find that different apps work differently depending upon whether you have Control F7 turned on or off and what other types of controls you're trying to use. So try it out with your favorite apps. Try it out with that turned on and that turned off and see exactly how it works. And after a while you'll get used to how your favorite apps work with these keyboard commands if you decide you want to use them. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.